All right, to start our bird feeders, you need to go in your recycling bin and find some kind of container, a milk container, a juice container, a nice tea container, and get one of these things. Make sure they're all rinsed out because you can see there's some gooey's in the bottom. I'm just using this as an example. So you rinse it out, and then with warm water, not scalding hot, but warm water, you can peel this off pretty easily without leaving some kind of residue because we are going to need this completely clean. Sound good? Okay, now this is very, very important. Once you do that, you need to do this project with an adult. We're going to handle some very sharp scissors, and we're gonna handle a poke, like a nail or a thumbtack. So you need to do this with an adult. Capiche? If you're not with an adult right now, turn this off. Okay? Let's continue. So once you have cleaned your container and you have taken off the little weird thing, what you're going to do is you're going to need to cut out a part of the container. I'll show you mine that I have made. See, I have cut out a part of my container. We'll get to the colors next. Cut out a part because the bird seed is gonna go in here. So you gotta make sure this is completely dry and empty. Clean, you can take off the top, you can leave the top on, it doesn't matter. So cut out a piece. I only cut out one part because this is quite thin. It's not so fat. So I cut out just one piece. With my other one, I did cut out two pieces. As you can see, cut out two pieces. That way the birds can come in. When cutting this, you do need sharp scissors. My normal scissors, like my normal ones that I have, did not work. I needed to use almost like meat shears that you use for meat. I needed to cut it and I needed to actually stab it first and then cut. So you gotta be very careful. An adult needs to do this, not you guys. Once you have as many holes as you want and it's cleaned out and dry, you can paint it. Now I have painted them tons and tons of colors. If you know me and my classroom, me and my co-teacher, we both love rainbows and we both love, love, love glitter. I don't have any glitter with me. I'm not in my classroom, I'm at home. So I only have paint. I did find that tempera paint did not stick well to the plastic. You will need acrylic paint to do this. So the paint that mommy or daddy uses, that's probably the paint that you play with, not the kid one, the adult one, that's probably what you're going to need to stick to this. Just a disclaimer to let you know. So what I did, I cleaned it and I let it dry for a day and then I painted it. As you can see, I did rainbow, reds on top, then orange, yellow, green, blue. I even did indigo, even though it looks kind of black. Indigo, violet, and then I did some, you know, white on the bottom. You don't have to paint the bottom because it's going to be hanging. For this one, I painted. This is the day scene with the sun, as you can tell. It's all roughed up with some clouds. You see the clouds there, there, and there. And the grass. I tried to make it two-toned and it didn't work out too well, but it's my project. I like it. So, and then I made a night scene. As you can tell, the stars, the half moon, and the grass. The grass came out better than my morning grass, but whatever. I like it. I thought it came out good. So once you are done painting and it is dry, you're going to have to take what I did. I took a thumbtack and I poked a hole, if I can find the hole I made, a hole in each side, as if you could see it, if I can find it and show it to you, right there. I poked a hole in each side. I did it on this one too. And we're going to take string or yarn. I'm gonna think that string will work better, if I can find where I put my string, than yarn, because yarn sometimes tends to shred when you're trying to get it through a hole. So I'm thinking that string may work better. So let me pause this and find my string because I have no idea where I put it. Okay, now that I have sneezed a bunch of times, I did find my string. So here it is. I did have white string. I don't know what I did with it. I just lost it apparently. So I'm gonna cut out a big strip. I'm gonna use scissors. Again, be careful with the scissors. There we go. Have my string. So let's see if I can do this one first. I'm gonna wet it so I can get it through the hole. Is it gonna go? Got it. I'm gonna put a lot through the hole because I need to stick my fingers in there and pull it through. And then I gotta get through the other hole. Go wet it again. And stick it through the hole. If I can do this, and I'm gonna have to do it like backwards and upside down. Let's see. I'm gonna have to pause this so I can look upside down and get it through the hole and then show you what it looks like. After some maneuvering and hanging upside down, I have got it. So you're going to take the two strings, tie them in a knot. You can make it long, short, whatever. I have quite weird branches, so I'm gonna make it kind of medium height. So I'm gonna tie a knot. Again, you're going to need an adult to do this because you guys do not know how to tie your shoes yet. I doubt you're gonna know how to tie a knot. So I'm gonna tie a really tight knot because the weather outside has been very crazy with our storms and with everything else. I don't want my bird feeder blowing away. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna cut string. There we go. So there is my bird feeder. Should we do my other one, my rainbow one? Because I like that one too. All right, let's do my rainbow one. So I'm gonna have to use the same string. I'm gonna cut it at medium length. Whoop. Oh, didn't cut. Oh, I shredded it. There we go. Much better. All right. My kids seem to be arguing. So I'm gonna poke it through the holes again, and I'm gonna pull through, and then I'm gonna show you what we're gonna do. Sound good?